Terry Barrett with the West Virginia Primary Care Association.
My name is Diana Rice. I'm the Community Outreach Specialty Clinic Supervisor.
My name is Sandy Swisher. I'm a family nurse practitioner here at Jefferson Health and Wellness Center.
My name is Nina Smith, and I'm an RN. I'm the Primary Care Nursing Director at Minnie Hamilton Health System.
My name is Barbara Cooper. I'm an LPN and the Care Manager at Minnie Hamilton Healthcare Systems.
My name is Adam Baus. I'm the Assistant Director at the Office of Health Services Research at the School of Public Health at West Virginia University.
The Diabetic Cardiovascular Grant came about through a HRSA grant.
We are currently in year three, so we're at the tail end of the grant, but the overall purpose of the grant is to improve health care. The Mid-Ohio Valley Rural Health Alliance is an integrated network made up of different healthcare systems, hospitals, health clinics, behavioral health, and public health organizations.
And as a group, being with the other community centers, share that information and see if we're all doing the same thing. And by working together, is, you know, sharing our practices, have we made a difference in those patients' outcomes? And I think that's the ultimate goal of it.
The two disease areas that this grant focuses on is diabetes and cardiovascular disease. For our grant project, the organizations decided to focus on diabetes in the second year of the grant. The first year of the grant focused more on getting the groundwork set up, getting the technology in place, so whether the organization was going to use a registry or electronic health records.
Our office was pulled in as a technical support group to help with data collection needed for the grant, to help standardize those data across the five participating sites so that we were really comparing apples to apples, and also to help provide feedback on the results over time with the different metrics that are being tracked, and where we can to help improve some of those measures where the needle needed to be bumped up a little bit.
The grant was used primarily to educate our diabetic patients. We bought them glucometers, we bought them test strips, portion plates, which helped patients realize that what they thought was an adequate portion or a small portion for a diabetic was actually way off base. So we handed out over 500 of them, along with what we call a placemat indicator about carbs, proteins, how to make your diet more diabetic and cardiovascular health.
What I think has been very beneficial is what we've been able to do for the patients as far as equipment. So we've been able to give them a monitor and provide them with the blood glucose strips for that to check their blood sugar the way they should be checking their blood sugar. That's been very, very beneficial. And then they bring those numbers back to me.
Monitoring patients, what their A1Cs are, their LDLs, and blood pressure measurements and things like that, and hoping to make improvements.
By using the grant, we were able to educate more than we ever could have done solely by ourselves, being a small rural hospital.
125 to 300 patients that were being tracked the first year is easily well beyond 10 times what it started out to be. Yeah. And what we've put in place is, I would hope, sustainable, because what we've been trying to do is integrate these efforts in quality improvement as a form of best practices that the clinic naturally does day in and day out. And these sites are all, they're innovative anyway, so a lot of what we're doing is just getting them to share what they do and what works for their patients.
And so I think overall that it's really helped, you know, helping patients set a goal and taking ownership of their disease, of their chronic disease especially, that, you know, if you don't have a goal, you don't know when you reach that goal if you've never set one. You know, whether it be something as simple as taking their medication or walking for 15 minutes every day or whatever. I think overall that it's really helped patients as far as making them more aware, and then the supplies have really helped them.
And we've been able to give people monitors who have not been able to afford, that they have the ability to do those things that you're wanting them to do. That's been the most beneficial, I think, for the patients.
We gave out 170 glucometers and 500 bottles of test strips to patients who weren't normally testing because they could not afford the test strips. That made a huge difference in giving patients control. And when you give a patient control over his life, he's more apt to be compliant, to do what we've asked you to do to make yourself better. But we'll take the data and the resources we've built from this grant to carry on with our patients. And we will continue to monitor them, to offer them the opportunity for glucometers, for test strips, anything we can to support them once this program ends.